I now call on Neil Bibby to speak to and move amendment number 2888.3. Mr Bibby, you've got 7 minutes.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I don't think anyone across this chamber would argue about the importance of parents in a child's life. Parents and other guardians are often the biggest influence on the life chances of children, and we know that children thrive in a stable and supportive home environment. As I've said several times before, we will work with the government when they are doing things right and challenge them when they are not. The Labour Party has a track record of commitment to supporting parents and children. The For Scotland's Children report in 2001 drew together an action team of experts from local government, the NHS and the voluntary sector to look at how better to integrate children's services. It was Labour who introduced Getting It Right for Every Child to ensure that all Scotland's children, young people and their families have consistent, coordinated support, and I'm pleased the SNP government is carrying on that agenda. On this side of the chamber, therefore, we welcome the Scottish Government indicating they plan to support parents and other guardians. However, we want to see more urgent action to support parents, and the truth is at this stage, Presiding Officer, is that in terms of the National Parenting Strategy in this debate, there is little so far to applaud or little to oppose. We have a debate here not to launch a consultation process or even at the end to discuss this strategy. The strategy is not yet tangible. And while the broad principle of a strategy that consults parents and seeks to support them with parenting is one that I think most people would be supportive of, the real test is still to come. But I'll take an intervention.
Minister.
My intention in having this debate today was, granted, a lot of the consultation work with parents who are facing particular challenges has been done, but this is to give the wider chamber an opportunity to shape and focus the way that we take the parenting strategy forward, and I would hope that opposition members would support that approach.
Neil Bibby.
Well, certainly, I'll give you some suggestions later in my speech. Better preparing and supporting parents with the responsibilities and opportunities provided by parenthood gives us the chance to set out how we would like our children to grow up here in Scotland. It is vital that we use this opportunity to do just that and crucially support parents rather than just lecture them. What we need to do is develop a strategy that embeds in our culture the idea that it is natural and indeed expected even that all parents need advice and support at some stage. We must challenge the stigma that says only vulnerable parents and parents at risk need a helping hand. That's why we on this side of the chamber want to see more action from the government to support parents and other guardians. We want to see the government deliver on the promises they've already made, and we want to take this opportunity to make some other suggestions too. We want to see the government supporting parents, including working with local authorities, health boards and the voluntary sector to improve the existing network of family centres, starting with those communities with the highest levels of deprivation. Family centres provide support and advice for parents, as well as specialised intensive work with vulnerable children. This can include play sessions, transition support, mentoring and respite. I know Labour and the SNP both had in their manifestos a commitment to a new generation of family centres, and so I expect we will see specific plans detailed about this in the strategy. We also need to see, as has been mentioned earlier, an action to increase the amount of free childcare and nursery provision for 3- and 4-year-olds. As we know, this was pledged by the SNP government back in 2007, and it could be introduced now with a simple piece of legislation. Instead, childcare measures are being folded into a children's bill that will take years to implement. Again, we want to see action to support parents and other guardians sooner rather than later. We are also supportive of initiatives such as the FAST project, Families and Schools Together, run by Save the Children, which aims to boost the chances of children in the UK's most deprived areas by supporting parents to improve their child's learning and development at home so they can reach their full potential at school. According to Save the Children, teachers report a 10% improvement in reading, writing and maths among children enrolled in the FAST programme after just 8 weeks, and 73% of parents also become more involved in their child's education. This demonstrates significant developments in a short period of time, and I was pleased to visit one such project in Clydebank late last year. We also need to see a corporate parenting strategy to improve our own performance as corporate parents to the most vulnerable children in Scotland who need our help the most. We hope and anticipate that commitments to these ideas are also part of the National Parenting Strategy. Presiding Officer, we need action from the Government to support parents and other guardians. And while the Scottish Government talks a good game about this, we would feel more confident about this had the Scottish Government commitment to supporting parents and had already delivered the promises they have already made. What better way for the Scottish Government to show it's serious about supporting parents and other guardians than to deliver on those specific promises? I mentioned increased nursery provision earlier, but another such commitment is on kinship care, where the level of financial support to kinship carers is less than the support to foster carers in far too many local authorities. We hear from kinship carers talking about patchy support depending on what local authority you live in. Patchy support is little better than no support at all. We know the First Minister did commit on 27 September 2007 to bring forward £10 million to fund financial support equivalent to that paid to foster parents. Further commitments have been made by successive SNP ministers that this promise would be met via the Concordat with local government by 2011 at the latest, and yet it's still not happening. Promising aid to those kinship carers in 2007, often elderly, often sacrificing to help children and who are not looking for massive sums but simply a quality of treatment, and then not delivering it, what does that say about the Scottish Government's commitment to supporting parents and guardians? If the Government continues to let down kinship carers, what hope do other parents have that this national parenting strategy will help them? If this Government is serious about supporting parents and other guardians, then it should deliver on the commitments it has made. Because, Presiding Officer, parents need support, kinship carers need support, and children need support, I hope we will see a national parenting strategy, a strategy of action that supports parents and children, that delivers on the promises made, and I move the amendment in my name.